Here's an example of some simple BLAS code. First, we initialize n to 2 to the 20th, or about a million, and then we perform SaxP. Remember, SaxP is the S is single precision, and that stands for AX plus Y. So we're going to set Y equal to AX plus Y by calling SaxP, and we're going to do this on a million elements, or more exactly, n elements. So here we're going to say Y is equal to A, which is 2.0, times X plus Y. This is the original BLAS code. If we want to run this on the GPU, then the first thing we're going to do is change the comment at the top. So the first thing we're going to do after we change the comment at the top is add a cuBLAS prefix and change these to be device variables. Next, we need to initialize cuBLAS and shut it down again when we're done. And now we need to allocate those device vectors and free them when we're done. Finally, we need to set the vectors, so copying the data over to the GPU and get the result back. Okay, so by the addition of just a few lines, we've accelerated this using cuBLAS. And I'll point out that, of course, if you were doing more than just this one simple SaxP operation, you'd probably leave the intermediate results. You wouldn't keep setting and getting your vectors back and forth to the CPU. You would do some operation, then you'd use the results to do the next operation and so forth. So a lot of this overhead really only appears once at the beginning and end of your calculation.